I don't want to set the world.
Hey everybody, this is A Cosmic Evolution and welcome to this game. Some people may, well, already see what game this is. I am not sure who it was who said I wanted to see the playthrough of this. I would really love to say his name. It's probably on the screen right now. And, well, I haven't done this game before now, or it has taken me so long. What has taken me so such a long time from the last playthrough to this one, I can explain later, because right now it's a beautiful cutscene with lots of good music and theming and, well, yeah. That sort of thing. So, I will soon stop talking and let you guys just enjoy the cutscene.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
And so the adventure of us begins. Look, it's a woman. And behind her is a man.
Let's see. Are you
who's played by Liam Neeson? Well, I'm not really sure I'm a boy, just to keep this moving on.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful
son.
Healthy baby.
I have
boy.
Put on subtitles so people can read what people say. I'm probably going
James.
To talk over everybody, so
we did it.
Bad luck. At the same time, I will not skip over anybody when they talk, because, well, someone would really like to read and enjoy the story.
Look at you.
I'm probably going to commentate over it and just have lots of fun with that part, and hopefully you'll also.
You're going to need a name, aren't you?
My name.
I've been talking. What do you think about?
What I think about player name. I enjoy it. It's a perfect name for me. No, I would like Ace Neeson.
That's a good name.
Because what other game can I call myself?
Finish the gene projection.
The son of Liam Neeson, and still be true. Okay, Caucasian. Character building. Going to just choose a preset. Army guy. Gay guy. Green Day guy. Cool guy. Old army guy. Gambler. Drug addict. Elvis. I liked preset number 6. Hairstyle, hair color, facial hair. Well, I should have that beard. It's close to what I have right now. Style. Ooh. I think there is. Isn't there one of the starting. There. Clean cut. Close enough. Yes.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that?
The cool thing about this game is that the character that Liam Neeson, or the character James, who is Liam Neeson, is modeled after Liam Neeson.
It's a big world out there.
But will change his appearance according to
what kind of person
what you choose. So if you have a really big nose, his will be bigger. If you are, well, of course, if you're black, he's going to be black. And etc. etc. Things will change. So, this is Fallout 3 for people who did not, well, did not see the starting credits and all that part, or can read the name of this YouTube film. Okay, we just skipped from our birth to our 1 year old birthday.
You'll hurt your eyes.
Okay,
something you could use.
Don't look straight into the lights. There.
Come on over here, son. Come on.
La 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 la. Hey, Daddy.
There you go.
I have lots of to talk about, but I kind of have to explain the basics of the game and make you do good choices at the beginning.
You don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute.
Close the gates without touching it.
While Daddy runs to his office, you'll be okay, pal.
I want to be free. Okay. Just run right here to the your special. This is the first place where you actually changes the playstyle and kind of build up your character. Okay, I'm just going to skip over this and I'm going to explain this part. Okay, strength. You start up 5 points on everything. You can increase or decrease. You have 5 points extra and 5 points on everything. This is a pretty average character. I'm going to have 2 on perception. I'm going to explain that later. Intelligence up to 9. If you are planning to go to level 30 and get 9 on everything, because that's a perk, I'm going to explain perks later. You should just keep it average. And you should not put everything over 10, because I'm going to explain that part later. Agility, charisma, 5, endurance, 6. Yeah, I like that. So, okay. the reason why I put down perception, I'm going to explain when we get out in the wild, so I can explain it in practice, not just in theory. The reason why I put everything up and intelligence up to 9 is because every time I go up one level, I get skill points. I can use them to increase, like, my ability to use guns and lockpicking and other abilities. And with and high amounts in intelligence, you will get more points for each level to put into each skill. But I did not put it up to 10 because in this game there are different kinds of, well, collectibles, which raises your skills.
All right, come on.
So, when I find the intelligence bobblehead, which is the collectible, my intelligence will be 10, and if it already is, then I will be wasting one of the bobbleheads. And also, that bobblehead is not hard to find, so I'll get the advantage of that easy and early. No, now I'm 10 years old. Happy birthday to myself.
Happy birthday.
Weird. I'm not 10 in real life, so I have to play 10. I'm 10 years old. Ooh, what's that? I can actually go out and... No, I can't.
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I?
You're mean. When you you're turn going 10, to shoot
well,
someone.
You're ready to take on your first official vault responsibility.
I'm going to kill you.
So here you are.
Nah, not.
As overseer, I
yeah, I'm probably going to play as a good character in this one because of, well,
get used to it. You will be getting your
on YouTube. Pretty much everyone either are complete badass and trying to kill everybody, or are a maniac and just does what the fuck they ever want. I'm not going to roleplay it because that's boring. Hey.
Happy birthday. We really
happy birthday myself, thank you!
Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
Huh, fuck you then. I'm going to read out... Yeah, okay. I'm going to read out my choices in the game so you people can hear it and don't have to read it. Great party, Amata. Thanks for doing this for me.
You're welcome.
Really, I'm 10 years old now.
Decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday.
Sorry for the mic. I want to switch it out, but I can't afford it. I want a date with something something candlelight, a girl named Hot Hot.
You know what I mean. Before you say something rude about me, I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who likes Grognak the Barbarian better than Mean Christine.
Mean Christine.
Who
the hell is Christine? I have to find out, Christine. Where is the hottie? Hey, Butch.
Hey, happy birthday, nice party, butthead. Now get lost before I have
attention
to make
everyone.
You
I can talk to him and I can get a baseball cap.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son?
It's really cool. Did you fix it up for me?
As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
Thanks, Stanley.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
Andy, wait!
Oh my god.
How's it going, pal?
Oh, fuck the cake. I've got something better. I've got...
Nice.
Wait a moment. Baseball cap. Baseball cap. Yes. Hey, old lady, little polymer. Blah, blah, blah.
10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness,
yeah.
Listen to me ramble.
It almost seems like 100 years since you came here also. Ooh. Yes, ma'am.
Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for
sweet
you.
Sweet roll.
You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
Hey, Birch.
What are you looking at?
Your fucking ugly face. What are you looking at?
Look, Butch.
I'm hungry. That stupid robot destroyed the cake.
So?
Give me that sweet roll you got from old lady's home.
No. I can't remember the last time. Can you have a sweet roll? Sure, Butch. Spit in the sweet roll. Nope. Go soak your head, Butch. I'm not going to give you a sweet roll. You do look hungry. Yeah. You do look hungry. What? Your mom drank up all your... drank up all the ration coupons again? Yeah, okay.
Don't you talk about my mom, you little punk.
Oh, fuck you. I'm gonna punch
you
out.
Sorry, you little smart.
Okay. Why? I can't... fuck's sake, you punched me.
Are you having a you're doing? Leave him alone.
Thanks for coming,
you
Stanley.
You alright, son?
I know you were busy with the water purifier.
Are you having a nice
What are you looking at, dork face? Me and Andy got her all fixed up again last night. Good as new.
Officer Gomez.
I'll send him right down. How's it going, pal?
I'm glad you can make it.
Hey.
Hey, that was John.
Sorry, I skipped that. He just says, run downstairs. Who's that?
Happy
Beatrice.
Birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party.
I'm not a girl. I'm not five. Stop calling me dearie.
Of course you're not five. You're
what
a big 10-year-old man.
Evil laugh.
Your very own Pip-Boy. And do you know what I did? Just for the occasion, wrote you a poem. I hope you like it.
Probably don't. A poem? You gotta be kidding me.
No, really. I wrote it just for you.
Wow, you're a blonde.
I never just copy one of my old poems. Well, there was that one Founder's Day where I couldn't rhyme anything with Overseer. But you deserve nothing
Overseer.
Else than a brand new poem. You can keep it in your Pip-Boy and
read
it with everyone.
What can you rhyme
with
Overseer? Actually, I can't. Well, if you can come up with a better word for, or get a fine word to rhyme with Overseer, please write in the description. Or, no, description, what the fuck? In the comments. I'm not some kind of kid, something I said just to him.
If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Oh, the start is so long. Yeah. Hey.
Are you ready for your surprise?
Yes, I am. What kind of surprise?
The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work. So, I figure you're old enough for this.
My own minigun! Oh, BB gun.
Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough
shape. Bitch-bashing gun.
It took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his.
Okay.
So, what do you think?
I'm going to take care of this weapon forever. What do I get to kill?
Easy now. It's only a BB gun.
This BB gun is going to be my most prized possession.
Let's go try it out.
It's made out of scraps made by my dad and stolen bits from Butch's weapon. The only way this could be better, if I got to kill him with it. Oh, miss. Not a good omen for this game. So, you can aim down the weapon and shoot. And you can also press the VATS button. Yeah, sure. That's an explanation of how. And then you can switch character to aim at, and you'll see there, torso 95%. That means I have a 95% chance of hitting with this bullet. And I can stack them. And as you saw, I stacked two shots at the torso, and both of them hit because it was such a high percentage.
Good work. Let's get a picture together. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me.
Sorry for skipping that. I said I'm not going to skip it, but some of this is just too boring to hear or to listen to. Yo, Dad. Pelvis.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy.
It's heroin.
Yes,
brew our heroin.
Class to take your goat exam.
Don't tell anyone.
You've got a goat to take.
Goat. Bye, Dad.
Take care, son. I got out of here.
I can't talk to him, and I've found a lot of information about, well, my mom and all those characters in the game and stuff and goat and dad and escaping and oops, spoiler. Okay. And here is one of the bullets I talked about. This gives me 10 points in medicine.
Good morning.
So now, if I put the rest of my points in medicine, I can get it up to 100 and save 10 points.
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
Okay.
God, Butch,
if
you
talk, okay.
Alone?
Explain the situation. In this game, karma is. Shut up. I'm just going to go a little bit back. In this game, karma is really, well, important for both your character and your choices and how people interact with you. Apparently, everyone can tell your karma before you talk to them. So, here she is picked on by three guys. You can either punch her, get bad karma, and they will like you. You can punch him and get a little bit of good karma, and she will like you. Or you can talk to this guy. You have a problem with Amata?
Stay out of this. It's tunnel snake business. Me and Butch were just having some fun with this chick.
Oh, I get it. Butch is the leader. You're just a follower.
I don't follow anyone. Wally Mack is his own man, and the tunnel snakes is where I belong. Why? You think
what,
Butch
you belong
is in charge?
Tunnels?
Is that what people are saying? Because it's a load of shit if that's what they're saying.
I heard you do anything he tells you. And I mean anything.
What? What
you
kind of shit is that? No one talks that way about Wally Mack. He's not the boss of me. Nobody's the boss of me. I'm out of here.
Yeah, fair warning. We're this is going to be here. Filthy because I don't
done.
Really have any...
Done.
Well, I have a foul language and I'm not going to hide it. And this game is meant done. For people up Let's to the ball. Age of 18.
Are you sure?
So... Butch? If you're 18 and don't like foul language, okay. Too bad,
whatever
I don't care.
Say,
if you're younger 18 and watch this,
fine,
I
go. I, was done here anyway.
I really hope you...
This ain't over, Daddy's
well,
girl. I'm not finished with you either,
I kind of understand because, well, people under 18 well, are probably going to watch this, and hey, I can't judge.
It really is
okay, here you can take just the goat, you'll go get some interesting questions, actually. You know what? See here. This has been going on for 24 minutes or some. Yeah, around that. Yeah. I am going to actually. This has been A Cosmic Evolution. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more videos. And in the next episode, we are going to continue off with the goat and the rest of the vault story. Bye!